Hello, this is Man in Tights. I am casting this tournament game between Tom Bigfoot, Dejah, and Keith. The game has just begun. Keith, with his first action, played the occupation Hill Farmer. Hill Farmer is a very interesting occupation. It lets you take food when you plow or fence based on how few houses you have. An interesting play by Keith. Tom took Greedstone food, and we're waiting on Bigfoot. While we're waiting for the next move, let's check out what the final score of the first game was. There it is. Okay, so in the first game, Bigfoot tied with Dejah at 45 each. Tom and Keith are just far back, 35 and 25 respectively. It looks like Keith is pretty much eliminated. Tom needs a huge game. Dejah and Bigfoot just need to keep their game above the water. Okay, so Bigfoot took 3 wood. Dejah went ahead and played the Mastermind occupation. This is a new France deck occupation. Let's check it out. Okay, this is the card that was once known as Notary. Whenever you play a card that has a point symbol, it has to be a positive point symbol card marker, you get a point. So that would be these three majors, the Pottery, the Joinery, and the Basket Maker's Workshop, and any other minor improvements that Dejah has, and potentially occupations that also have point markers on them. Keith took 2 wood with his second action, which is slightly unorthodox with the Hill Farmer. You usually expect Plow to take the 2 food to utilize the Hill Farmer to its maximum efficiency before playing that first house. Tom took 2 clay. Bigfoot played the House Goat, one of the strongest miners in the game. It gives you 6 food and it's a free point, essentially. It does have a drawback that you can no longer hold animals in your house. Okay, Dejah took the plow because there was nothing better for him, apparently. He probably has some kind of interesting food income that he'll get for the first round, because otherwise, day labor for 2 food is probably a better move than a 2-point plow. Early food is very important. Bigfoot starts out with 2 reed. He's clearly going straight for that first room. Dejah takes Reedstone food, not surprising, as reed is the most sought-after resource in the first rounds of the game, as people are trying to get first rooms to get that first family growth. Usually, the person who builds the first room will get the first family growth in the family growth queue. Interesting to see how they're doing this. Okay, now we see that Keith played the Turkey Breeder. The Turkey Breeder is a wonderful card from the New France deck. It gives you a loan of 4 wood that you must pay back at the end of the game, but it doesn't actually give you the wood. Instead, you automatically build 4 fences and 1 stable. You can place the stable in or out of the fences. I've mainly seen it played with the stable going in the fences, giving you more animal space for the early sheep that came out. It was a wonderful play by Keith, especially after the Hill Farmer. He got 2 food, and he will now have room to take those sheep. I'm still wondering why he didn't take plow last round, but we'll see. Tom went ahead and played the fiddler. The fiddler says that whenever you don't get any resources in a round, you receive a wood. This is a very strong card when you have 2 family members only. After you get 3 or 4 family members, it's hard not to take resources. In even numbered rounds, it also gives you food, so this round expect Tom not to take another building resource with his second action. He'll probably take plow, day labor, or grain. Dejah is now waiting on him to turn. Bigfoot took 3 wood. He's already got the resources for his room. And Dejah plays 5 rings, which people have already been commenting about as the strongest of the cards in the new France deck. Five rings gives you a discount based on the card that you, based on the resource that you paid for this card. If you paid stone, you get a discount on every single improvement that costs stone later on in the game. If you paid wood, you get a wood discount. Dejav obviously played stone, which is the stronger of the two discounts. I've actually not seen this card played with a wood discount ever. Okay, now Bigfoot, now Keith came out with his plow, which is not at all surprising. I'm still curious as to why he didn't do it in round one, but we'll see what he's got planned. Perhaps he has the Oceanographer card. And there's the day labor that we were expecting from Tom, so he gets a wood and a food. Well, remember that Bigfoot and Dejah have a 10-point lead in this game, so all they really need to do is hold the other players at bay, especially Bigfoot holding Tom at bay. As Sebash mentioned in the chat at the beginning of the game, Bigfoot is in a very advantageous situation where he is seated in front of Tom this game, so he can take starting player and essentially leave Tom last in many rounds, putting Tom at a huge disadvantage and essentially nerfing his game and allowing him to not. Or disallowing him to catch up. It will be interesting to see if Bigfoot employs that strategy. So far, he's played starting player already once this round, this game, and we'll see how that goes on. Dejah opened up with a four wood action, a very strong action that doesn't usually come around in round three, but here it was. Tom took redstone, Keith took redstone food, unsurprising. Tom played the humble farm boy. It's a 4 wood occupation. You get 4 wood. 4 wood occupations are mainly powerful in the fact that they let you get a surprise extra wood pile at the beginning, which pushes you ahead for the early family growth and house building. Now, there were 2 3 wood piles on the board, so it may not have been the best of plays. Interesting to see how that 4 wood occupation combines with the fiddler. We'll check that out in just a second. Bigfoot played the hut builder. He gets a room on round 11, provided he's not in a stone house. Dejah went ahead and took traveling players, bringing questions back to why he plowed in round one and not took day labor then. But we'll see. Maybe he has a use for that early field. Now we're waiting on Keith. Let's check out how the fiddler combos perhaps with the humble farm boy. No, the fiddler will not combine with the humble farm boy since Tom received resources. Therefore, he's probably going to make a resource grab with his second action. This really leads me to questioning why Tom didn't take 3 wood or 4 clay with his first action, and then with his second action, take occupation, which, disregarding which one he took, would cost him 1 food since it was his second occupation. But we'll see. Either way, he's probably going to get a nice pile of 3 wood or 4 clay back. So we can expect Tom to take his resources now, and next round he probably won't take resources, and we'll see what goes with that. Okay, Keith played the card Grotto. Grotto's an interesting card and wonderful with the Hill Farmer. Every round you pay, if you want, you may pay 2 food to receive 1 resource among 3 clay and 2 stone, which you slowly buy them all up. When they're all gone, you have an extra room for your family member in the Grotto. So it works really nicely with his hill farmer. And as we already mentioned, he's going to get the sheep, which later on with the fireplace or a cooking hearth will give him lots of food, which will power the grotto more than just taking plow and 2 food, which would also be a nice way to power it. We see now that Tom took 3 wood. That's a good, it's a good grab to take 3 wood. It could, would have been interesting to see what would have happened had he left the 3 wood and saw what would happen with a potential 6 wood pile. But maybe he doesn't want to give that to Keith, so we'll see what happens now. I expect Keith to take plow or fencing somehow this round to get an extra 2 food to take the next resource from his grotto. And he took 6 clay. I was expecting him to take the sheep. We'll see, he may not be able to afford another resource from his grotto at the end of this round after Tom plays the fireplace now. He's going to need to grab the sheep, and then Keith will not be able to fund those grotto resources, and that will push his family growth off by a whole round. That was a big miss by Keith, in my opinion. Tama had him piled up more wood instead of taking two reed or reed stone food. An interesting play, because now he does not have resources to build a room, which would almost guarantee to have been a second room. This also gives Bigfoot an opportunity to take reed stone food or two reed and push the other opponents back in the reed race. We'll see if Bigfoot had other plans or if he's going to go ahead with that. Not knowing his cards and in a vacuum, I would say he should probably take three reed stone food here to push back Deja, force him to take the two reed, which will in turn leave Tom without any reed and keep Tom from getting a room, which will push Tom back. And as I've already mentioned, Bigfoot and Deja are ahead of Tom by 10 points, and that would be really huge for him to keep Tom, who's his closest competition, from advancing to the next round, from getting any more resources here that will help him get advantages towards the room and thus family growth and so forth and so forth. Yep, and there's that Reedstone food grab. Okay, Deshiv should probably take two reed here, since he does want to build a room. And if he doesn't take the two reed, then Tom will, and then he'll be in trouble. He'll need to wait a whole other round. It makes a lot of sense that Deshiv will be able to take two reed here, and he'll definitely get the two wood spot back. He may even get the three wood spot back, and that would be good for him. Oh, he started with the cookies. I wonder what that's going to bring about. He's clearly abandoning the room pursuit now. And we'll see. Okay, cookies. For each round that you bake, you can put one food on your rooms out of among the food that you baked for per each grain that you bake. It's essentially a pelts for baking if you're familiar with the card pelts. It's a very nice card for extra points if you have a strong baking game going on. And we'll see. Okay, so Keith took the fireplace now, which is a great move for him because the sheep are hanging around for him now. He doesn't need to worry about someone else taking them. I thought previously that Tom would buy the fireplace after Keith took six clay, but Tom went ahead and took four wood. So Keith gets a breather here. His sheep are going to advance to five, whether they're in his farm or on the board. And he'll get a whole pile of sheep, and that will be very nice for him. Though, as I previously mentioned, Keith does not have the food to buy the Grotto resource now, and that will push his family growth back around. Tom took his two reed, as we expected, that it was left around, so he'll go ahead and get into the family growth queue. Oh, Dejif played the miser. That's a very interesting play, because now Dejif does not need the reed or the wood to build a room. He could build a room with four wood and a reed. The miser says that whenever you build exactly one room on a build room space, you may pay one less of the type of room building resource, wood, clay, or stone, and one reed less. So four wood, one reed is enough for Dejif to build a room, and he will grab that room ahead of Tom, which is good for his game, in addition to being good for his overall picture in the tournament of setting Tom back and not really caring about Bigfoot. Now we see here, Sebash predicted that Dejev had the miser over there. So that was very, very good by Sebash predicting that. He saw Dejev's move. The importance of being able to predict your opponent's moves in Agricola, it is in fact the most important element. There is no other greater perception of skill as to the ability to predict your opponent's moves. If you can see what your opponents are doing, you can then order your moves that you had planned in the most optimal way that they would be left for you. And then you could take, let's say that you had two moves that you really wanted, and one of them you assumed would be contested and one you wouldn't. You would take the contested move first. That would put you in a big advantage of you getting moves that you deem to be useful in following your plan. Usually, Agricola players do badly when they are set back from their plan by them getting distracted, either by having other moves that are seemingly more appealing that distract them. Or, like now, Dejev just took six wood as opposed to building a room. Maybe that was a bad move. Or when they had a plan and it was not going along because other players kept on taking the spots that they wanted. Usually that comes from not being able to predict other players' moves well enough. So it's interesting to see how the other players, especially the watchers right now, especially someone like Sebash, who already advanced to the next round in the tournament, is at predicting the players who are currently playing. If he could read the players who are playing the game, he will have an advantage if he's seeded against them in the next round. Okay, so Dejiv took 6 wood, probably because stone came out and not family growth. Presumably, if family growth came out, Dejiv would have built a room and left the 6 wood for Keith. Keith took redstone food, which is really strange because he still doesn't have food to buy another. He doesn't have 2 food now to buy another resource on the Grotto. He's almost definitely going to take the 5 sheep with his second action. So just so he'll be able to buy that Grotto food, that Grotto resource with food, and not delay his game even further. Tom built a room. Now Bigfoot has no choice but to family growth if he wants to set Tom back in the greater picture of the game. But if he wants to play this game specifically, Bigfoot would probably be better off just taking 4 wood or continuing with his other game plans and letting Tom waste his actions on starting player, hoping for that family growth and not having Bigfoot have to waste anything on the family growth queue. Because if Bigfoot now comes and takes starting player and in round 6 there's no family growth, then Bigfoot will have to take starting player again. He's wasting a lot of actions. And he does have food right now. He has 3 food after the harvest and the house goat. So he has a lot of food. He can afford the turns, but. And as far as the game is going, his actions would probably be better letting Tom starting player. But in the grand scheme of the tournament, since he wants Tom to be last in everything, having him start, and now he's going to start again, if family growth doesn't come out, and if it comes out, then Tom will be okay. But if it doesn't come out, then Dejif is going to be able to build a room. The next round, Dejif will take starting player, and Tom will be pushed back all the way to last family growth, and that will keep Tom out of the game. Okay, so we see that Bigfoot did start. Dejiv went ahead and took 5 clay. That was a strong move. 5 clay is always a huge pile of resources that's nice to grab. As predicted, Keith went ahead and took the 5 sheep, and he is going to obviously kill one of them and take his Grotto resource at the end of the round. Tom went ahead and got that 4 wood, which is a nice big pile of wood. Tom is doing very well on the wood front, but he's not doing so well on the family growth front. He will only family growth third. And if family growth does not come out, he may even family growth fourth. Okay, Bigfoot just made a very interesting play. He played the expert builder, which is an interesting occupation. Every time any player builds a room, they place one of the resources that they paid for the room on the card, and then later the player who played the card can use these resources for either building rooms or renovations. This card is not such a strong card. It nets about 4 resources, 5 resources a game, and only while building rooms and renovating. And he already missed 1 room built by Tom and 1 room built by himself, as well as missing that Keith played the Grotto and the Hill Farmer. It doesn't look like he's building any rooms. So it's interesting to see how he played the expert builder, but he needed a second occupation for his improvements, which he now needs to push out while either waiting for family growth or taking family growth. Ah, family growth came out in round 6, so he took it. He played raspberries. Raspberries, you get 3 food that you place on your board. When you use the 3 food, when you use the spots, you get the food that's on that space. Raspberries is one of the strongest cards in the game, as far as miners go, because it gives you 3 food. It gives you a free point, and it only has a 2 occupation prerequisite, which is relatively easy to get out of. We saw Bigfoot was able to play his expert builder to get the prerequisite for it. Previously, I missed it. Bigfoot played the swimming studio on his starting player that round. It costs a reed. Whenever you take fishing, you can pretty much fry a wood into 3 food, which is very nice. When you so now, 3 food fishing would turn into a 6 food action for Bigfoot, and he's probably going to do very nicely with that. Dejiv started with the grain cart. Knowing that no one can build, and that's pretty much forcing Tom to do a poor move of the stable box. So that was a great move by Dejiv, further lowering Tom's move output as far as value goes. He played the miner of the grain cart. Whenever you take grain, you get another 2 grain. It's one of my favorite grain cards in the game. And with the cookies that he played previously, Dejiv is setting up a very solid baking grain game. I would not at all be surprised to see him take 3 stone next round if he does indeed get stable blocked over here. Okay, Keith played the engineer. The engineer is a occupation. Whenever you play an improvement, you get food based on whether it has a stone cost or not. If it does have a stone cost, then you get 2 food. It's a strong occupation. It's a strong occupation when played before you play two improvements, for instance. He already missed out on two food from it, but it's still a good one. It's his third occupation, and it looks like he's going to be building the well with his next action. Or next round on renovate on renovation. He'll build renovation well, get two food, get five food on the next rounds. Really feed his Grotto needs and move on with that. Okay, Tom just threw a wrench into what we thought. We thought we were going to, everyone here thought that he was going to take stable block, I'm sure, to build stables and keep Dejah from building a room and stealing his family growth. But he didn't. He went ahead and played an occupation, the animal breeder. The animal breeder is one of the stronger occupations in the game, as it allows you to buy animals when you take fences. When you build a fences action on an unused farmer basis, you can buy a pair of animals for one, two, or three food, which is relatively cheap. If you have a cooking curse, this could be a make every fence action a five food net gain. It's very easy to get animals breeding, which is by consensus the strongest or most stable way to feed your family throughout the game, is having your animals, especially cows, breeding. But Tom doesn't have any cooking improvements right now. He didn't get the he whiffed on the first fireplace. He doesn't have clay for a cooking curse. And he doesn't have any food right now, and the next round is the harvest, so that could be a little bit dangerous. As expected, Dejah built a room, and Keith built the well. Bigfoot's second action also took the three food fishing, which I expected would happen, and he cooked his wood into three more food, so he's got eight food and the house goat. He's doing very well on the food front, and he has the first family growth. Keith is looking, Bigfoot is looking pretty strong. Keith is having an interesting game there. I think it was very much to his detriment that he did not get family growth coming out in round 7. That would have put him at getting it in round 9. He will get his Grotto. His Grotto will be available now. He's going to buy a clay. He's going to buy a clay at round 7, buy a clay at round 8. His Grotto will be available at round 9. He would have been able to family growth in round 9 had family growth come out in round 7. It would have been 7 Bigfoot, 8 Dejah, 9 Keith. But now he's going to get hopped over by Tom, and it's just not looking so great for Keith. Once Tom is starting player, we could see Bigfoot now. He might take three reed and then wood, and by the time Tom family grows, Bigfoot will already have another room, and he'll hop ahead of Keith. Also, Dejah has the miser. He's almost certainly planning on building a fourth room, and that will also probably hop in front of Keith. So Keith could be in trouble here. Okay, but he just got a very nice six wood grab, so that I guess is to his advantage, and we'll see. He might fence here for more food. He has the well. He has the hill farmer combination, which is very nice when you only have two rooms. We'll see where Keith's game goes. And right now, it looks like Dejah is doing really, really strongly. If he can feed his family right now, he has the crib, so he's going to take two food at the end of this round. It was an excellent miner for him. The crib allows you when you take family growth at the end of the fa work phase. When your people go home, you either get to pay two food for a point or take a point or take two food. Dejah will obviously take two food, which is by consensus on the site considered the better move. And then he only needs two more food. I expect him to go ahead then and take three grain, which will get him the grain he needs. He'll eat two of them. The third one, he'll buy the clay oven with a discount from his stone ring, so he'll only need three reed for that, three clay for that, and he will get. It will be a very strong move for Dejah to go ahead and get that clay oven. We'll see. Maybe Keith will snatch it from him, but I doubt it. Okay. Tom took starting player. He played the clay roof. He needed to take starting player in order to get the family growth next round. That's actually not true, but he played the starting player. It means now that at the beginning of the next round, he'll get to take whatever nice actions out there. I really don't understand why he did that move. Bigfoot took four wood. It's a strong move. Dejah took day labor. Surprising that he didn't take three grain. Everybody's commenting on that now. Also, you see here JML is commenting on it, and Sebastian is commenting on it, that Dejah missed it. He could have taken three grain like I thought he would. Then he would have had the clay oven for five food. This is going to set Dejah back actually a lot. This is about a five food action for Dejah. A five food mistake. Okay, JML's pointing out that Tom is going to be really stuck as far as food goes next round. It's possible. I see Tom taking family growth and then a cooking curse, and then he's going to hopefully grab a three food spot and then fence, and he'll be able to buy cows. Okay, so now they're discussing again that Tom has the fiddler. We'll see if he remembers that, and he goes ahead and he gets his wood, and in round eight he's going to take family growth and cooking curse, it seems, so he'll get his wood and his food. As expected, Bigfoot took three reed. He's going to take three wood most likely here, and then he's going to get another room, and he'll be able to hop ahead of the Grotto. I take that back. He played the Amazon. An interesting card to play. The Amazon is considered one of the weaker WM cards made. Whenever you use fishing in rounds 7, 9, 11, or 13, you get to receive an animal based on the round. It's a relatively weak card because it's very constrained as to when it is useful, and not many people take fishing. But apparently Bigfoot is going to be taking fishing every time it hits 3 or 2 food, when it hits 3 food in round 9, and when it hits 2 food in 11, and 2 food in 13. And so he'll get animals out of this. This is good for him. It goes very nicely with his swimming studio, which he's going to be cooking his wood. Sebastian is commenting now in the comments that the Amazon with the goat, with the house goat, is not a really good combo because the Amazon gives you an animal, but the house goat takes up the animal's place in your house. So he's going to need to have fences or stables in order to use that. I expect him to build a stable at least when he builds a room in the upcoming round. Tom renovated and took a fireplace. Wow. That was strange. I really expected him to take a cooking hearth, which would be worth a lot more with his animal breeder. Sebastian is commenting here that he probably has a cooking hearth miner, because otherwise it would not make sense for him to do that. And when he takes family growth, when Tom takes family growth, he'll be able to replace that with the miner, and that would be very good. Now with Bigfoot's go, I expect him to take starting player, but he didn't. He took the four wood. Keith will be able to take starting player now and save his family growth in round 9. I was sure Tom was going to go ahead and steal that. Not Tom, Bigfoot was going to go ahead and steal that, but no, he took his four wood, which is also a good move. He eats wood. Everybody needs wood for fences and probably a stable. And well, we'll see. Dejiv goes ahead with 3 stone food. That's a strong move, usually. Especially for Dejiv because he has the discount on stone improvements, and he could buy the pottery now with that stone. It's interesting that Dejiv invested in the five rings early in the game, and he hasn't used it yet. The discount card on stone. Here, I'll pop it up again. Whenever you play it, you get a discount on stone based on what you paid. He paid stone, so he hasn't used it. It's interesting. It's a slightly wasted resource. Dejiv is not playing the strongest game right now. Keith went ahead and grabbed the sheep, which is very important for his food, but this gives Bigfoot an opportunity to steal his family growth again. If he takes starting player, but then Keith will build a room and Keith will be okay, but he'll lose the hill farmer advantage. I'm not even sure he wants to use that advantage. Dejev just pointed out that Keith is going to go ahead and get the last resource from the Grotto now on Bigfoot's turn. This is really giving knowledge to Bigfoot that he may have missed, though I doubt it because Bigfoot is a solid player. And well, it might change what Bigfoot is going to do here. It probably won't. If Bigfoot takes starting player, Keith will build a room, and that will hurt Keith. If Bigfoot builds a room, Keith is going to take starting player, and he'll get the family growth next round, and that will be that. We'll see what happens. Tom, as Sebosh predicted, played the minor improvement cooking hearth, replacing his fireplace that he bought last round. So essentially, he spent his action building this action on the improvement on family growth. He spent it taking one clay. So if he had nothing better to do with his improvement action, then taking one clay there is a fine move, but otherwise it's confusing as to why he didn't just straight up build this Cook and Kirk and play a different minor improvement that would have been stronger for him at the moment. I don't know what he has, so I don't know whether he did the correct move or not. As expected, Bigfoot went ahead and built stables with his room build. He's obviously expecting Keith to take starting player, and I expect him to go ahead and take wood with his last action, allowing him to get the fishing for six food and the boar next round. Dejiv took his three grain this time around, which has what we expected him to do last time, and I expect him to go ahead and build the clay oven next. Keith started with the open gate, which is a really nice miner for Keith because he has all these sheep. The open gate, every harvest you can release a sheep to the supply and get a point. So this is looking like a 5-point miner for Keith because he has all those sheep. And it also cost a stone, which gives him two food with his engineer. So it was a really nice play by Keith, who really isn't doing so badly. With the well, with the open gate now, with the family growth coming in round 9 that he didn't get stolen from him by Bigfoot, it's really looking nice for Keith. Bigfoot obviously is very much in control of this game. And there's the three wood that we expected. And here now let's see Deja build that that clay oven for three clay. I wonder if Tom remembered to take his wood food. We'll see. Tom gets a wood food from the fiddler, which he played in round 1. In this round, he family growth and he built a renovation fireplace. Since he didn't take any resources, he should get a wood food. JML is saying that Tom has not taken it yet, which I guess we can see clearly by the fact that there's no food here. That would be really good big for Tom to get those food, because he's kind of starving right now. And every food helps when you're starving. But it looks like he left it there. We'll see. We'll see when his turn comes around whether he took. Oh no, he took the wood food. He just didn't announce it earlier. And now he just took the two boars, which is six food for him if he needs it, which he does. So one of the boars is obviously going to live on in his room, but the other one's going to die. He's got four food. He'll be okay with the family growth in this round, especially because now he can play his animal breeder and he can take his fences and get cows, and those will probably be very big for him. I expect Tom to take fences, cows, and take to fences, buy cows with three food, and then he'll need another two food to pass the harvest and have his cows breed, and he'll probably do that with a traveling players or fishing spot. It'll be very powerful for him to take fishing and to block Bigfoot's fishing action, which gives Bigfoot a lot of food. And seeing as no one except for Keith can fence now, well, maybe Bigfoot will go ahead and revenge fence on him if he did that. Tom should probably fence first and then take fishing. Bigfoot went ahead and took four wood, which is always a strong action. Dejiv is starting player right now with the lumber, which means that Dejiv is going to make a move on the room. Which is very interesting. It means he might have to eat a grain. Maybe he won't make a move on the room, and maybe he'll just do sow, bake a grain for five wood, for five food, and sow his grain and get that harvesting and make a more reliable grain supply. This way he doesn't need to keep taking grain and then sowing in order to keep his baking feeding game alive. But he might make a move on the room. It will be an interesting play to see what he does. As JML pointed out here in the chat, the lumber, which was the miner that Dejev played, was free. As Dejev has the stone rings, this is actually the second time we've seen him use it now. Earlier he played the clay oven and baked a grain, and that was also a stone discount. So now he's already used the five rings twice, and it's good to see that he's doing that. He also, when he baked that grain, he made a cookie and he put it in his room, and so that is a good point for him. Okay, what have we seen since then? Keith took renovation and the pottery. As expected, Keith is staying at two rooms. He wants to keep that hill farmer bonus alive. The pottery is a nice minor improve a major improvement for him. It cost stone, it gave him an extra two food. There's plenty of clay this game, it seems. And so he'll be able to continue eating that. He might get a full bonus for it. It looks really nice. As expected, Tom went ahead and built fences and took those cows. And Bigfoot, seeing what Tom is probably going to do, went ahead and took his fishing and protected it, not trusting that it would come around. And he cooked his wood for three more food, so he just got six food. Bigfoot is going to be surviving this harvest very, very smoothly with 10 food there. But he doesn't have a greater feeding game right now, which could be worrisome. But we'll see. It could just be that he'll make do taking two food fishing with the extra burning of the wood for five food on the odd numbered rounds, and picking up random food on the board. It could be that that will be enough for him. Dejev went ahead and built that room. And he's also going to be able to take Sobek. What I missed last time when I was speculating about Dejev's move was that I did not take into account that Dejev did not refresh his farm after he picked the lumber and take his wood. So he immediately had the resources for a room there, which I missed. So now Dejev will be able to both build his room and steal the family growth, and he'll be able to Sobek. That was really nice for him. And now they're speculating about Keith having perhaps the lighthouse as to why he would stay in two stone rooms, in two rooms specifically. The lighthouse is a very powerful card if you're staying in two rooms. Once you're in stone rooms, you get another room for a family member. It works just like the treehouse card in G, which is a card that many consider to be overpowered. That one works in clay, and there are no limitations to it. The lighthouse has a very big limitation that you must be in two stone rooms. Okay, Tom went ahead and took his three food to keep his cows breeding, and he's going to eat three food and the boar, and his cows will breed, and his feeding troubles seem to be behind him. Bigfoot, who should be slightly disappointed at losing the family growth out to Dejef there, and also doesn't have nearly as nice of a improvement and occupation game set up there, is looking a little bit weaker now. Even though he has nine wood, which is eight more than Dejef has. So as far as Bigfoot versus Dejef right now, Dejef has a really strong setup with his grains sowed now and his baked grain setup, and he has the crib for extra points, and he has the mastermind for extra points. Dejef is doing very nicely as far as points are concerned, and he's also going to be the first one to four family members. Dejef is definitely in the strongest position in the game. I'd say that Keith is probably in a stronger position now than Bigfoot, because Keith has all these improvements for all those points. It looks like he's going to go ahead and push with the lighthouse. If he takes three stone, we could see him renovating and then playing the lighthouse. That would be a surprise move, perhaps, for Bigfoot, though he might see that coming. So we'll see how it goes. We will indeed. There, as expected, Dejah baked his grain, made another cookie, sowed the grain, and he was able to pass the harvest nicely. He family growth here without an improvement, which is seen as a missed opportunity, but here he's first to four family members. He's in such a far ahead position anyway, as far as that goes, that I really wouldn't be feeling too bad if I were him. As expected, Keith went ahead and took the three stone. It looks very likely now that he has the lighthouse. I expect Bigfoot to see this. And take starting player with his first move. But we'll see when we get to Bigfoot's move what he'll do. Tom is now fencing and carrying on with his animal breeder game. This is exactly how you play an animal breeder game, if you are out there wondering how it's done. You buy a cooking hearth, you buy cows. It makes every action a five food action. Your cows breed, which will give you four food every harvest. And you get more room for animals, which you will then go ahead and take the lesser animals, sheep and boar, because cow is already out, and that's going to be the contested animal that the other players are going to be jumping for. So this is how you do the animal breeder game. Now, as far as the ceiling for the game for Tom right now, he really doesn't have any points and improvements down here. And he doesn't have any resources that really suggest that he's going to get more improvements. So if this is a high scoring game, Tom is definitely going to lose. If this is a low scoring game, Tom might win the game, but he's not going to outscore the opponents in the proportions that he needs to. He needs to outscore Bigfoot and Dasher by 10 points. Playing a three-room animal breeder game is not going to get that done for him. So Tom's strategy is clearly not looking at the big picture right now. So that's unfortunate for him because it seems that he's going to get eliminated. Now it's Bigfoot's go, and he should take starting player, and my internet has gone down, so we're going to go ahead and reconnect. And we'll see what I missed. My internet is still down. I'm going to set up a portable hotspot, and we shall fix this problem. Oh, the internet is back. Okay, so as expected, Bigfoot took starting player, and he did not have a minor improvement. I don't think, unless he played one and it was taken already. Oh, there it is. He took the wild game. The wild game lets you kill a boar for 5 food, which is really nice because he got a boar when he took fishing with the Amazon last round. Bigfoot is utilizing cards that are not so great right now, and he's doing quite well with it. Okay, now that this is very. Okay, Dejah took clay, and now Keith goes ahead and he takes reed, which is definitely going to help him get the basket maker's workshop now if he renovates, which we're expecting him to when he's on his way towards that, what we expect to be lighthouse. It may be that he's just going to be taking things like the basket maker's workshop and then using that stone for other things later on in the game. It could be he doesn't even have the, it could be he does not even have the lighthouse like we all anticipated earlier. What they're commenting in the chat right now is that Keith and Tom are prone to playing small room games, whereas Bigfoot and Desha play what is known as near family growth, a term Ish coined. Ish is a one of the legendary players on the site. That if you just focus on family growth and you do well getting those family members, you will win the game most of the time, Ish says. Most of the time being 35, 40% of the time. You will win if you focus on getting your family members faster than the other opponents, because then you will have actions to do things that they cannot do. You obviously need to support yourself with feeding. We see that both Bigfoot and Dejah are in 4 rooms. They're both getting to their fourth family member, and they're both capable of feeding their families right now, which is very interesting and good to see. Bigfoot took vegetable. He's clearly focusing on the crops aspect of his game, or he just deemed all the other spots on the board to be less good than vegetable. I find that hard to believe with plow and 3 wood over there, and they're probably a better action than vegetable. Dejah took redstone food, as mentioned before. That's a great move for him because of his stone rings. He now has the resources to buy the stone oven on renovation. I expect to see that next round after him taking 3 grain. As expected, Keith renovated to stone and took the basket maker's workshop. He took 2 food for his engineer. Let's focus on the last move that Tom had. He played the card Trailblazer. Trailblazer is a card that, whenever you don't have any empty plowed fields on your farm, you pay a food to plow at the beginning of a round. So this could be a 4-field card for Tom if he plays it properly. He needs to get some kind of resource that he can sow on his field for round 11, but he didn't. He went ahead and he took sheep, which is also a solid move. It's getting his food moving along, getting his animals breeding. At the beginning of round 11, Tom will obviously pay a food to plow a field. And we'll see how that goes. We'll see if he can cover that field with a resource. It would be very good for him to get grain or vegetables sowed next round, because then when it comes around to round 14, he'll be able to sow them for a lot more. Probably grain, because he's going to want to sow those again, those fields again in rounds 12 and 13, both to make the Trailblazer worthy of being played and worthwhile, and because it will give him enough grain that he can max out that resource. If you sow grain once in round 11 and once in round 14, you will not get to 8 grains. You'll only get to 7, so that won't max out your score. Okay, it's a new round. Bigfoot is first, and he's the only one who has room for a family member, and there's 6 wood on the board. This looks like a no-brainer decision. 6 wood for Bigfoot. Let's check the score. Okay, there it is. So according to the scorecard right now, Bigfoot has absolutely 0 points. And as mentioned, he doesn't really have the support of the points. and the improvements. Now he could take two. Obviously, he took six wood. Ah, he had the hut builder room, which is really nice for him. So he got a fifth room now, and he'll be able to family growth again in round 12, unless if Keith starts with the lighthouse like we expected. Now I thought maybe he would take two cows because he has the stables, but then he doesn't really have room for them to breed, and he gets a resource when he takes fishing. He gets a cow when he takes fishing, so that will go ahead and occupy a space in his stable. He doesn't have room in that because of the house goat, so definitely six wood was the better move there. Dejiv went ahead and took four wood because Dejiv is really starving for wood right now. That's the only minor drawback of his game, is that he doesn't have wood. We expect Dejiv to take three grain and then the stone oven later this round. Keith plowed because he needs to plow. Plow is a very important move at this point in the game. Each plow is worth 2 points, and at this stage in the game, you already have your family members. You want your family members to go out and do something that will get you points. And plowing is really important in that respect because it's guaranteed 2 points per action, which is a relatively high output of points per action. So Tom went ahead and took starting player to get whatever comes out in round 12. He doesn't really mind, I don't think, whether it's plow, sow, or family growth. I'd actually, if I were him, be hoping for plow, sow. Because then he can get his fields covered, and that will help his trailblazer get more fields on the board. As expected, Bigfoot then went ahead and took his fishing cow, ate a wood for another 3 food. It's Dejiv's turn. Let's look at the other scores here. So as we said, Bigfoot has, well, now it says that he's got 3 points, because he got the cow, which was 2 points, and he built the wooden room, which was 1 point. Tom has 8 points because he's got all these fences already. He's got the animals, but he really has a weak farm and only three a weak improvement in occupation support system, and he has only 3 family members, so he's not going to advance points very quickly. Whereas Bigfoot is very quickly going to outpace Tom, getting about 4 to 6 more points a round than Tom. And so, with 3 rounds left, that means he's going to score about 12 to 18 more points than Tom. And since he's only down by 5 right now, it was looking very good for Bigfoot. Tom does have the milking stool, the humble farm boy's out there, but it looks like Bigfoot is winning that right now. So Tom is really not doing well at beating Bigfoot. Dejiv, as we said, is having a really powerful game. He's, though it looks like he's only got -1 points according to the scorecard, he has 2 points for his cookies and 2 points for his mastermind, so he's matched with Bigfoot, and as far as that goes, he has more actions already. He's got a huge pile of clay. Dejiv is definitely doing nicely. I expect him to build a fifth clay room later on in the game. Keith now went ahead and took those 2 cows. One of them is going to be worth 2 points for him, the other one he cooked for 3 food, which is a very strong move for him, mainly because it takes the 2 cows out of the game for other players and really hurts them. And hurting your opponents is good for you. You heard it first from me. Okay, there's family growth by Bigfoot. He played the beehive, an improvement that takes 3 occupations and 2 improvements as a prerequisite. It now shows why he played these not so strong occupations. He played them out just as he would be able to play raspberries and beehive. He's not really using them. Well, he's using the Amazon very nicely. He's not really using the expert builder so well. The resources on that have not been huge. He got one resource from himself when he built that room. He got one resource from Dejiv when he built that room. He has one read on it for his renovation. It was worth about 3 resources. Not the strongest of cards, but he needed it for his prerequisites, and that's a large part of his planning in this game. Okay, so Keith went ahead and took wood, which is important as everybody needs wood. He's got enough wood now for 13 fences, which is probably the amount of fences that he should go for. Remember also that Keith needs to get 4 wood for his turkey breeder to pay back at the end of the game. Otherwise, he's going to take begging cards, and that will not be good for him at all. Tom's actions took vegetable and soda as expected. I really thought he should have taken grain and soda. I didn't notice if he took the grain before Dejiv took clay or not. But he should have definitely taken grain, both to block Dejiv and to sow grain, which would have been better for him. Dejiv now, as we expected, took renovation stone oven. He baked a lot. His food is well done. I wonder if he took a point with the crib or not. It looks like he didn't take a point with the crib last time, which in my opinion is a mistake. When you have a huge baking game going, when the crib comes out and your family grow thing, you want to pay those two food for the point because you have nothing better to do with food at that stage. Food is really cheap for you. Tom got his family growth, which is slightly disappointing for him. I could see him being unhappy with that. Now means that he's probably going to need to take a lesser sow action or just give up on the field next round with the Trailblazer. Probably going to take the Trailblazer. Sabash is commenting that Tom forgot the fiddler, which is possible. I didn't notice. Last round he took vegetable, he took sow, and he took starting player. So yeah, he forgot the fiddler. That's a bummer for him. Now it's Bigfoot's turn. Bigfoot has no fields, and he has no plow. And so I expect nothing other than plow right now because he needs to get fields if he wants to get those points in the game. Another thing to look at is that perhaps he should take four clay so he can renovate the clay. Because if somebody else takes that clay, he'll be starved out of clay. There are only six more clay coming into the game and two different action spots for the rest of the game. So if he doesn't take clay and he misses that, he's stuck at wood, and that's a big outlet of points. That's a road that he cannot take to get more points. So plow or four clay seem to be Bigfoot's good actions right now. I also expect Dejev to want to plow. I also expect Keith to want to plow. Plow is the hot action right now. So if I'm Bigfoot, I'm taking plow. And if clay gets taken, then so be it. JML is commenting that it looks like Keith has the bragger. It's very possible that he does because he played all these improvements. He's got four major improvements already. That means that you only need to play five of your seven minor improvements. And his minor improvements look like minor improvements that are relatively easy to play also. With the engineer, with the style of play that he's been playing, it looks very likely. I think that JML might be right. As expected, Bigfoot took his plow, and we're moving on to Dejah. Plow would have been ideal for Dejev. I expect Dejev to take starting player here or to take Reed. Probably Reed, because he has nothing to do with nine extra clay, which is what he's got right now. So if he gets Reed, he gets to build a room. He'll get to family growth next round. He might take starting player with this action, and then take Reed, and then take the room. And next round, open it up with a plow cell, and later family growth with his last peep. So we'll see how that works. Looking ahead to Keith's farm looks like he needs to just go ahead and fence. If he does have the bragger, he's going to need to focus on playing improvements, meaning he probably might take starting player to get family growth next round. We see here Dejev took wood. He's focusing on his fences, which is probably the right move for him. It looks like Dejev is going to be fencing a whole lot of spaces. Look for Dejev to be fencing at least eight, if not nine spots. I think he's going to build a fifth room and try to plow a second field and fence the eight other spots. So we'll see. Here's Keith predictably playing an improvement and starting so he can get family growth next round. He played the lumber. I don't know if he paid for it or not. If he had two stone, then he definitely doesn't have the lighthouse now. We can guarantee that because otherwise he would have played the lighthouse right there. He played the lumber. The lumber is a great card for him to have passed to him by Dejev because it has a stone cost. It gives him two food for his engineer. It gives him three wood, which is a resource that is very needed by everyone in this game, especially by Keith, who both wants the fence and keep wood to pay back his turkey breeder. Moving on to Tom. Tom fenced, which is what you do with the animal breeder. He bought more cows. And he's keeping that food alive. He's got five cows. He's got the milking stool. That means he's going to get three food in the upcoming harvest. He also has two wood left, which is enough for one more fences build. It could be. There are only three more fence out actions left in the game. That's it. And four people still want to fence. There's a fences action in round 13, there's a fence in round 14, and a Reno fence in round 14. Somebody's going to miss on the fences. If I had to put a guess right now, I would say it would be Dejev. Since he has the least amount of wood, it also seems to be the least worthy for him to pursue it. It's just not worthwhile for him to pursue it. If he takes three, he builds his room, he builds his stables, which with his four, which is with his eight wood, he's getting 4 points for the stables instead of 6 points for pasture. That's eight fences. It's a fine trade-off when you don't need to worry about the pressure for fencing, which is getting to be a really tight picture right now. So yeah, he went ahead and he took Greek Zone food. I see nothing other than a room coming his way. Let's focus on Bigfoot playing this France card Immigrant Son, which is a really nice card if you're playing all your occupations. When you play your fifth, sixth, and seventh occupations, you plow a field. This is really good for Bigfoot since plow is really contested. There are also only three plows left, and not too many people have plows. No one has played a plow. This will give Bigfoot an alternative opportunity to get plows out. Now he needs to play three occupations in order to maximize the utilization of this in the next three rounds. Let's look to see him sitting on occupations, but I would even not be surprised to see him taking it again now with his action that's not family growth. JML is commenting here, this is interesting, at what I commented at the beginning of the game, that he's not sure if he's ever seen someone use five rings for a wood discount. People have only been using it for stone discounts because it's just much stronger like that. Turn is currently Bigfoot's, so I missed a whole bunch of turns. So let's see what happened. Deja took Greek Zone food. Keith took vegetable, getting his crops going. That's a good way to get points. Tom took grain, getting his crops going. Also a good way to get points. Since he's second next round, he will be able to plow sow after Keith takes family growth. And that will be very, very nice for him because it will also open up the trailblazer for him and will plow a fourth field for him in round 14, which is really nice for him. Bigfoot went ahead and played the occupation I expected. He played the house steward, a wonderful occupation to play here. This is usually an occupation we play seen right at the beginning of the game. It's one of those race cards. Whoever gets the most rooms gets 3 points, and it gives you 4, 3, 2, 1 wood left based on how many rounds there are left. Now, Bigfoot only got one wood from it right now, but he played it after everyone else, except for maybe Dejev, is not building any more rooms. So this is guaranteed points just for him and Dejev. Keith and Tom are locked into less room building strategies, and this is going to give Bigfoot and Dejev 3 more points. So now, if Tom had any consideration of getting into the next round, he needs 13 points to get ahead of Bigfoot and Dejev instead of just 10. Really, really good play by Bigfoot. Great draft pick also with the strategy of the game. And it looks good enough. On his improvement, he played the farm school. The farm school is when you harvest at least two resources, you can play two food to play an occupation, which is brilliant with the immigrant son because now, if he all Bigfoot needs to do is take a sow action in round 13, and then he's going to be able to play his last two occupations in the harvest and plow his two more fields, and he's going to get a lot of points from that. So big turn of events there for Bigfoot. He's looking incredibly strong right now. He has 14 wood for his fences. He's going to get his cows breeding this upcoming round if he manages to fence and take fishing. But sowing is also a priority for him. We'll see if he can do it all, because Dejev needs to sow bake in order to bake. Tom will want to sow in order to get his extra field for his trailblazer if Keith surprises us and takes plow sow instead of family growth. A lot can happen here. This is going to be an interesting couple of rounds. Let's look at the score again just to see where people are. So Tom has 22 points, which is what we expected with him. He has a great farm. He has no real improvement points. And he has three family members. Now he has four family members. So he's going to score around the low 40s, it seems. Maybe 45, maybe 46. Getting fences again, he's going to get to plow two more fields. He's going to get his crops really moving forward, and we'll see him around the low mid 40s. Bigfoot is at 15 points officially. He's got the house steward, which is 3 more points, so that's already 18. He's got his fences, so that puts him up to 28 already. He's got his extra field, that's going to put him into the 30s. He's going to sow. He's got 10 more actions. I don't see Bigfoot scoring less than 46, 47, 48 points in the game. He's probably going to top 50, and definitely beat Tom and advance into the next round. Okay, let's see Dejev. Oh, the round started. Look at that. So Keith started with fences, which, as I said earlier, fences is a really tight action, and Keith, acknowledging that fences is such a tight action, just went straight out for it. The disregarded family growth, disregarded plow sow, went straight for the fences action, which is a big, big important point action, and he made sure that he got it. Tom took his plow sow, which he really needed, and now it's Bigfoot's turn. Now, I think that Bigfoot really needs to take six clay here. If Bigfoot takes six clay, he'll be able to renovate and renovate fences. And it doesn't look like anyone else is pretty close to renovation right now, so he'll be able to guarantee his renovation 5 points, renovate fences, make sure that he gets the fences action. It looks like Deja pulled out of the fence race. He built only two stables, not four stables. I wonder what he's keeping those last four wood for. Bigfoot decided to just disregard the opportunity to go to renovate fences, and he's just starting to guarantee that he gets that fences action. Now no one can stop him. He started player no minor. He made sure that he's going to get the right thing next round, which is really important for him. Just guaranteeing those points and guaranteeing that he gets to where he needs to go. Dejev, as I mentioned before, built a room that will be great for his cookies, that will be great for his house, for the house steward bonus. And he built only two stables, not four. I'm surprised. I wonder what he's got using forward for. Maybe he's planning on fencing once. It's possible. With the two stables, he took two cows. That's really nice. 3-point action straight up. And that was really good for him. So Family Gross got left for Keith, and he did not take it again. He took boars. This is slightly mind-boggling to me. Maybe he thinks he needs the points, but he needs the food, but two boars over Family Growth is, in my book, a terrible move. Dejev did not take sell, which was an interesting move for him because it would be very good for his baking, getting his cookies going, getting his food for the next round, and blocking Bigfoot, which would be really huge because now Bigfoot did get his sell, which was what I said earlier as a priority move for him. And now he will be able to harvest his resources, play his occupations, and plow more fields. That was really nice for Bigfoot. Very fortunate for him that Dejev did not go ahead and block him. But then again, Dejev and Bigfoot are not competing this game. They both just want to go ahead and score as many points as they can, and more importantly, score as many more points as Tom as they can, than Tom as they can, up to a negative 10, where they'll still advance. So now Dejev is just going to move ahead with his game. We'll see if he goes and he takes forward, hoping to get that wood spot, or hoping to get renovation fences. He took 3 wood. That will guarantee Dejev getting his renovation, because there's definitely going to be either reed stone wood or 3 wood, 3 reed coming back to him. So Dejev is going to renovate fences, and Tom is the one who's going to be beat out of that last fence, and that hurts for him with the animal breeder. He only got to fence 3 times and not 4. Did not utilize it as much as he could. Keith really needs to take 4 wood here because he must pay back those woods, or else he's going to take beggars. And so I hope he remembers that he has that, because otherwise he's in trouble. And that will really set his game back. So we'll see. And yep, he took the 4 wood there, and that's good. That saved him a whole lot of negative points. Good move by Keith. His food is fine. He's really got a ton of food. His animals look nice. I just don't understand why he didn't family growth last round. That was mind-boggling. But Tom said, thank you, took it. We plowed a field here, which doesn't give him anything. The Trailblazer would have plowed that field for him next round, and here he is plowing that field. That was terrible. I have no other word for it. That was really a wasted action by Tom. It could be that he's lost the thread of what he has. He's forgotten the filler a couple of times. He could be moving on. It might be that he's a little disoriented or by getting starting player on. And now he'll be last next round. I don't know what's going on with Tom there, but that was the surprising move. He wasted an action for one fruit, essentially. Oh, I could be that I'm wrong. The Trailblazer says at the beginning of the round, and he's not going to have no empty fields at the beginning of the next round because the vegetable is going to be harvested. I take that back. That was a great move by Tom. I'm sorry, Tom, if you're listening out there. Good move. 2 points. I missaw that. My bad. Okay, Bigfoot goes ahead and he takes his fishing, cooks. He took a sheep, which is 2 points. Since he only has those two stables and he doesn't have fences right now, getting an extra cow will be useless for him. It will only be 1 point. The sheep is 2 points. And because sheep might grow out to be 4 sheep next round, I guess he considers that boar will be more easily available than sheep for the last 2 points that he's missing. I expect Bigfoot to fence these 13 wood. 13 wood for 3 pastures covering these 6 farmers' bases. He'll plow these 2 fields with the occupations coming out. I'm still surprised he hasn't taken 6 clay. The pottery is owned by Keith. Keith is out of action, so Keith won't take those 6 clay right now. But renovating would be really big for him. Dejah went ahead and took the 3 reed. And he's got enough for a renovation. It looks like Dejah might have a mansion. That would be really interesting to see. It'll be really interesting to see if Dejev has a mansion. He's only missing two stone off of getting the mansion. The mansion is a card that gives you 2 points bonus for each stone room that you have at the end of the game, so that would be a 10-point card. It's the most expensive card in the game that I know of, in at least of the EIKW and France decks that are in the tournament. It's definitely the most expensive card. It costs a whopping 11 resources, 3 wood, 3 clay, 2 reed, 3 stone. And all he needs is 2 more stone and he's there. And what makes me think that he might have it is that he saved 4 wood instead of building 2 stables. So I think that he's got the mansion coming. That's what I expect to see coming out of him, and that will be really, really big. It will be a big point swing. Going into the last round here, let's see. With Tom's last action, he played the Milking Can. He has a Milking Can, Milking Stool combo. He's getting 6 food each harvest. He's going to get 3 points from each of the Milking Can and the Milking Stool. That's really nice. Dejev played the Loom, which costs 2 wood here, and it's a renovation. No, it's family growth. So I don't think he has a mansion anymore because there he went ahead and he burned those woods. He probably would not have done that if he had the mansion coming. Also, it's worth noting that Dejif only has one more improvement in his hand that he started with drafting because he already played 5 and the lumber, which he passed onwards. So he'd have to have the mansion there. Well, maybe he does. I don't know. He definitely got a renovation. He has those 5 clay. I don't know what. What they're speculating here is that he's going to build another room, and then he's going to renovate, and he'll have 6 rooms, and that will give him just more points because he's got a lot of rooms. And that could be very nice. I expect Bigfoot to go ahead and take Wheatstone food there. Yes. Now, Bigfoot has Wheatstone food. Bigfoot has a lot of food. He took the traveling players there, he took fishing. He's got enough food, he's finished with food for the harvests. He'll need a little bit more. He has to play the occupations now. He played the carpenter. Now, it would be really useful for Dejev to build another room here also, because then he would take the house steward points away from Bigfoot and possibly finish in first place in this group as opposed to in second. And that would be very important for seeding in the next round, where we will see 2 first place players from each table and 2 second place players, that he'll be placed with 2 second placers and 1 first placer as opposed to being placed with 2 first placers. That will be a more advantageous position for Dejev. Now that Tom and Keith are really mostly out of the game, I would say it's not correct to say that Tom's out of the game. He's doing nicely as far as points go, but he's definitely not out in the big picture. He's out. He's going to be eliminated. Bigfoot's not going to lose. They both have 30 points according to the scorecard. This is not a game that Bigfoot is going to lose to Tom in the long run. And Keith is there also with 31. Maybe Dejif is the one who's really far behind because he doesn't have any fields and he doesn't have that. Maybe Tom would beat Dejif here by more than 10 points. I might be missing this completely. I could have been way off here. Well, Dejif can take 6 wood right now, and he'll be able to renovate fences for a huge amount of points. He'll get 5 points for the renovation, and he'll get 6 points for the fences, and that would give him 11 points, and that would put him up to 27. Plus the mastermind, plus the cookies, plus the loom. The loom's not really giving him anything, it's one more point. But plus the mastermind, and plus the cookies, and the crib, which he still hasn't taken points for, oddly enough. But with all those extra bonuses, I especially see he's got 2 more food right now. Oh no, he doesn't. He didn't pay for the harvest. That was interesting. But no, he left those wood on the board. I guess he's confident that they're going to come back to him, and you know what? They might. And he took plow. So plow sow was also a huge action for him. It was worth 3 points for the plow, and a whole bunch, and another 2 points for the sow. So, or another 1 point for the sow. No, it was 2 points for the sow. He sowed 2 grains. He got to 6. So that was a big move by Dejev. There's the braggart that JML predicted nicely, coming out of Keith's hand. So that puts Keith up to 40 points. Definitely in position to win the game, more than 40 even, because he has the sofa. The sofa's an interesting card here. I missed it when he played this, but at the end of the game, if you have 2 rooms, you get 4 points. If you have 3 rooms, you get 2 points. And since he has 2 rooms, that's 4 points. That's a great card. So he's got 4 points for that. He's got the open gate points are really coming. for him. So he's definitely in position to win the game. Keith is. Bigfoot took stone, looking like he's going for the Reno fences. And he has the clay roof, so he has it. Because now Reno Fences is going to go to Tom. Tom's going to get to renovate. He's going to get to fence. Dejif is not going to get to fence, and he is in big trouble now. We might see Dejif getting eliminated here. He might be beat by 10 points. He just missed a lot there. This could have been a huge break for Tom. Unfortunately for Keith, who's playing the best game here, I think maybe Bigfoot's playing a better game, is that he's 20 points behind. He has no chance. But Dejif is in trouble. That's no question. The Dejif Tom score proportion right now. Let's try to analyze that. Okay, so it says here that Dejif is 21 points. He's got 4 points for the cribs. And he's got another point on the loom. And so that puts him up, and he's got another 3 points in the mastermind. So that puts him up to 29. Whereas Tom, who I predicted to get to around 40. So he's going to renovate fences, Tom. And that's going to get him another 5 points plus boards. So that's going to get Tom another 8 points. So Tom's got looking, we're looking at 38 points for Tom. Then they got the milking can, milking stool, both of which are worth. Both of which are worth 3 points. He's got the humble farm boy because Bigfoot started playing all those occupations, and Dejif has all those improvements. So Tom's got 9 points over there in these red ones. So he's already got 39, and Dejif is looking in big trouble right now. We'll see how he gets out of this. Bigfoot went ahead and took so, and Bigfoot is doing just fine, especially with Dejif flailing right now. Bigfoot is really doing okay. He can finish the game with. Let's say 40 points, and he'll be fine. I'm really surprised he didn't go ahead and take the renovation resources earlier, but now it's already pointless for him because both Dejif and Tom are going to be the renovators this game. Okay, so now they're discussing what Dejif should do here. Now, Horace suggested Dejif should take 6 wood, but Sebastian said definitely not because the 6 wood doesn't get him anything. And here, Dejif just went straight up and renovated. And Dejif is looking at his food feeding game right now, and he's not feeling confident with that. And so he renovated, he bought that cooking hearth, and now he could eat those cows. Nope, he did not renovate. He may be holding out for that renovation fences still, which is surprising. He just. Straight up bought the cooking hearth because he's worried about feeding. And now Keith plays the Swan Lake. Excellent play. That's a 4 point play for Keith. It gives him his ninth minor for the braggart, which maxes it out at 9 points. And it's 2 points. That was really nice. Horace is suggesting that maybe Dejif has the half timbered house. I still don't know if he won't build that sixth. No, he's definitely not building a sixth room now. So I guess that Horace is probably right. He must have something like the half timbered house. I hope that is enough for Dejif to stay alive in the game. He's going to get 5 more points on his renovation, but Tom's going to get 8 more points on his, and that's Tom's renovation is a bigger move than Dejif's renovation, and that's going to keep Tom in the game. Okay, so there's Tom's renovation fences. Boom for Dejif, but Tom bought cattle because he needed to feed. He did not buy boar. I thought he would, but you need to feed. You need to feed, but he didn't really need to feed. That's not true. Because he has the milking can, he has the milking stool, and he could eat his sheep. I think that boar would have been more points. And there, Bigfoot went ahead and took his boar that he predicted would be easy to take. There's a 4 sheep spot out there. Really interesting. We'll see if Dejif grabs it now or if he's still worried about his food. Let's see. Yep, Deja went ahead and took the sheep, so now he's done feeding for the game. At least he even gets another wound point. Yay. And that was also a 2-point action for him. So it was 2 points, it was food, it was good. Keith ended the game taking clay, which was a 3-point action, which is a nice move for him. He's going to eat a boar, he's going to breed his sheep, and he's going to finish the game with three people, which is a little weak because each person's worth 3 points. Really, that's why I would have taken boar the family growth the round before, but to each his own. That's what he's got playing for him. He might need a sheep, let another sheep go with the open gate. The open gate should be worth 4, maybe 5 points. I don't know if he's counting the actual point for the open gate on the card. The scoreboard that we have here does not count points for bonus cards. Tom plowed 2 points, very good move. It keeps Deja from plowing, which is now the main crucial battle here is Deja Tom. See who will advance, because Tom all of a sudden has this opportunity to go ahead. So we'll see. And here, Bigfoot went ahead and he took the wood, and it looks like he's just going to build stables and cash out his game. Very nice game for Bigfoot. He did enough to get himself into the next round, I think. He's got his it says 33, but he's also got the house steward, and that's 36, and he's also got his extra field coming out, and that's already going to be 38. He's going to build his stables, and that's going to be 40. He's going to get his last occupation, that will give him something, and 40 points. Tom's not going to score 50 this game, is he? Doesn't look like it. Maybe it does. He's got 47 already. It could be that 40 points won't be enough for Bigfoot either. Maybe Tom will be the real surprise and take first place in this group. I don't know. It seems I mispredicted Tom's points. I did not expect him to get that extra fences. Strange plays went down in the last round. I was expecting Bigfoot to renovate fences and Dejav to or Keith to fence. And as a result, Tom is surprisingly pulling ahead here, and he blocked Bigfoot's stable there, and that's a huge whiff for Bigfoot there because he doesn't have any opportunity to play an improvement out by the joinery, and his wood action just looks for naught. And wow. This has been a crazy turner of events for Tom. Great stable block there. Keeping Bigfoot down in the points. Now it might even be between Bigfoot and Dejah to see which one of them gets eliminated. I am surprised. Bigfoot's last action here was just to take. Let's see. He took a cow for one more point. And Bigfoot's swelling. He does have that extra field coming, and he does have the 3 points from the house steward coming. And he's going to finish with 39 points, and that is unfortunate for him. 39 is definitely not going to be Tom. Now they're speculating here that Tom has 48, so Bigfoot's going to be okay, but that's not true. Tom has more than 48. Okay, strange things are happening on my board right now. But we're back. Okay. So, Sebastian is saying that Tom has 48, but I don't know what Tom. Oh, Tom took day labor there with his last action. And I don't know why. Oh, Bigfoot pulls out a big one. Oh, Dejev has 48 points, Dejev is saying. Really surprising. I did not see that coming. I don't know why Tom just took day laborer there. Grain would have been worth a point, whereas day laborer was not worth a point. Oh, he took grain. Well, maybe he didn't. I don't know. Okay, so the game is over. That's it. Let's rack up the points and see who advances. So, Tom, Sebastian predicted he'd get 48, and he has 48, even though I thought he got. If he didn't take day labor, he would have had 49, had he taken grain. So, maybe he has 49 anyway, because it's cheap breed. Let's see. Dejif is reporting 48. Tom is reporting 50 because he took grain and his sheep will read. So that's why Tom gets that. Let's see how Dijak gets his 48 points. He played the half-timbered house. That's what they were predicting here. So that made his renovation move a 10-point action. His loom gave him 1 point, and his... Let's see what he's got here. Half-timbered house was also worth a point towards his mastermind, which is very nice. So his mastermind is 4 points. He gets 3 points for having the most rooms. That's seven. His cookies were another four. So that's already 11 over here. 12, 17 bonus points, and that is 48. And okay, so Tom scored 50, and that's not enough to beat either Bigfoot or Dejef. So Bigfoot and Dejef go on to the next round. Bigfoot's final points. He's got 36 over here, plus the house steward is up to 39, plus the wooden hut builder gets him up to 44, and that is enough to go on. And Keith's final score, it's hard to see exactly what it's going to be. I can't tell if his open gate is 4 or 5 points. His sofa definitely gives him 4, his bragger gives him 9, and he's looking at 17, 18 external points. That's 54, and that's a win for Keith. Victory's not going to get him anything more than bragging rights, though, because he's going to be eliminated after his terrible first game, unfortunately. So, final score of this game looks to be 50 for Tom, 44 for Bigfoot, 48 for Dejef, and 54 or 53 for Keith. Congratulations to Keith on winning this specific game. Well done. Congratulations to Bigfoot and Dejef on their advancement to the next round. And this has been Man in Tights casting this game. It's been a pleasure. I have an exam tomorrow morning. Let's hope that goes well. And good night.